Welcome back to our English class.
In the last class, we discussed up to the second question of answer in detail, isn't it? Do all of you write down that answers to your notebook? I think all of you had done it. Now, we can discuss the third question. What is the third question? What happened when Peter went to the tool shed? What happened there when Peter went to the tool shed? The answer is, from the gooseberry net, Peter rushed into the tool shed. Then he jumped into a water can. When Mr. McGregor was looking for Peter, Peter sneezed aloud. Then what happened there? McGregor tried to catch Peter, but Peter jumped out of the window. Isn't it? No need of studying this answer, but you have to write down this answer to your notebook. Okay. Then, fourth question. Name the different birds and animals Peter met in Mr. McGregor's garden. Did they help him? Which are the birds and animals Peter met in the garden of Mr. McGregor? The answer is, Peter met some sparrows and mouse in the garden. The sparrow helped him, but the mouse did not. This answer you have to study also, okay? Then, fifth question. How did Peter finally get back home? What did he do once he got back home? How did Peter get back to the home? Then Peter saw the gate when he was hiding in the wheelbarrow. Then Mr. McGregor had his back towards Peter. Then what happened? Peter jumped out of the wheelbarrow and ran as fast as he could. He slipped under the gate and ran without stopping till he reached home. At home, he just lay down and shut his eyes. You have to write down this answer fully to your notebook. But for studying, you just only study. Peter jumped out of the wheelbarrow and ran fast as he could. He slipped under the gate and ran without stopping till he reached home. That two sentences only you have to study, but you have to write it fully to your notebook. Do you understand? Then next one, think and answer. It was the second jacket and pair of shoes that Peter had lost in a fortnight. What does this tell us about Peter? What do you understand from these words? What do you understand? Is this sentence tell us that Peter was a very naughty rabbit, isn't it? He lost his jacket and shoe many times before this. Do you understand? No need of writing this to your notebook. Just hear it, okay? Do you think Peter enjoyed himself in Mr. McGregor's garden? Give reasons. Do you think Peter enjoyed in Mr. McGregor's garden without hearing the words of mother? He get into the garden and did he enjoy in the garden? No, why? Peter did not enjoy in Mr. McGregor's garden. All the time he was running, being afraid and crying, isn't it? And at last he found out the way back to the gate. He cannot able to enjoy. Why? Because he was very afraid. Mr. McGregor is following him. And he was very afraid. Do you understand? Then next one. Know your values. Veer, Harish and Tina visit their uncle's home. Their uncle shows them a basket of mangoes and tell them to pick up only one each. Harish and Tina pick up 3 mangoes each. They also ask Veer to take 3. But Veer obey his uncle. In the end, Harish and Tina get sick with a stomachache, but Veer does not. Here, there is a small story of Veer, Harish and Tina. And their uncle shows them a basket of mangoes and tells them that to pick up only one each. For pick up 1 mangoes each. Then what did our Harish and Tina do? Harish and Tina had taken 3 mangoes. Then what happened? And they said to Veer also to take 3. But obeying uncle, what did Veer do? Veer only take 1 mango. Then at last what happened there? At last Harish and Tina got sick. They feel stomachache. But Veer does not. Why Veer does not? Veer obey uncle and he take only 1 mango. So he did not feel any sickness. Do you understand? You have to obey your parents. You have to obey elders. You have to listen to them. Okay. It is for your goodness they are saying so. You have to obey your parents. Obey your teachers. Understand all of you? You all are good children. So you have to obey elders. Okay. They are telling you for your future. So you have to obey them. Do you understand? They are well experienced than you. So you have to obey your parents. Obey your mother. Obey your father. Obey your teacher. Do you understand? Then you will be a very smart children. Do you understand all of you? Rules are made by those who love us to help and protect us. Why I am saying you to obey elders or obey your teachers? They are telling these for your safety or because of the love towards you. So you have to obey. We must always follow them. We must always obey elders. Do you understand?
You have to write down the question answers to your notebook. This is for today's class. Hope you understand the classes. Thank you, my dear children. Assalamu alaikum.